Hello. Most of the time, you cannot immediately see a solution of a given differential equation, and you may not have a single idea of where to start looking for one. For so-called linear differential equations, however, I will show you how you can sometimes wiggle your way to the solution. First, let me tell you what a linear differential equation is. It is a differential equation that can be put in the form y prime plus p of x times y equals q of x. For example, the differential equation you see on the slide is a linear differential equation. Here the function x squared plus 1 plays the role of px and sine of x plays the role of qx. This form is called the standard form of a first order linear differential equation. The term linear refers to the way in which the unknown function y appears in the equation. There is a term with a y and a term with a y prime, but there is no y squared or root of y prime or sine of y or whatever. Here's the second example of a linear differential equation. It does not have the standard form because y prime is multiplied by x squared, but it can be put in standard form. Namely, divide both sides of the equation by x squared and it becomes y prime plus 2 over x times y equals x to the third. So after all, this second example is a linear differential equation, and when it is put in standard form, we observe that px equals 2 over x and qx equals x cubed. Now take a closer look at the left-hand side of the second example. Recall that the solution of a differential equation is a function y of x that makes both sides balance. To stress this, let me make the variable x and the variable y explicit. Now note that 2x is the derivative of x squared. Because of that, the left-hand side is the outcome of the product rule applied to the function x squared times yx. Namely, the derivative with respect to x of x squared times yx is equal to the derivative of x squared times y plus x squared times the derivative of y, which is exactly the left-hand side of our differential equation. So the equation can be written as the derivative of x squared times yx equals x to the fifth. This, of course, means that x squared times yx itself must be equal to a primitive function of x to the fifth, which equals 1 over 6 times x to the sixth plus c for some constant c. This gives us the implicit solution. And if we divide by x squared, we find the explicit solution, y equals 1 over 6 x to the fourth plus c over x squared. Unfortunately, it doesn't always work like that. Indeed, in the previous example, it works nicely because 2x is the derivative of x squared. In the following example, we are not so lucky. Look at the linear equation y prime plus 2y equals 6 and try the same procedure. Then we need a function, say mu of x, such that the derivative of mu x times y is equal to y prime plus 2 times y. Such a mu does not exist. Namely, at the same time, mu must be equal to 2 and its derivative must be equal to 1. That cannot be, can it? Now here's a nice trick that can help us out. Multiply the whole equation by a function of x such that afterwards we are able to apply the product rule in reverse, as before. Where do we find this factor? Let's see what happens if you multiply the equation by x squared. Then the equation becomes as you can see. Now that we've put the equation in this form, can you recognize the underlined part of it as the outcome of the product rule? If so, you're smarter than me. There's again no mu of x, such that the derivative of mu times y is equal to x squared y prime plus 2x squared times y. Now if I tell you that one of the factors, x, e to the 2x, and e to the minus 2x works, can you figure out which? Okay, let me show you that the second factor does the trick. Multiply by e to the 2x and the equation becomes as you see on the slide. E to the 2x y prime plus 2 e to the 2x times y equals 2 e to the 2x. And guess what? The new left-hand side is equal to the outcome of the product rule. Indeed, the derivative of e to the 2x times yx equals 2 e to the 2x times y plus e to the 2x times y prime. The function e to the 2x that did the job is called an integrating factor. Now we can solve our equation. We know that e to the 2x is an integrating factor for this equation, so we multiply the equation by e to the 2x. The equation becomes, as on the slide, and it can be rewritten as the derivative of e to the 2x times y is equal to 6 times e to the 2x. We conclude that e to the 2x times y is a primitive function of 6 e to the 2x. So it must be equal to 3 e to the 2x plus a constant. Divide both sides by e to the 2x and you find the explicit solution y equals 3 plus c times e to the minus 2x. In general, you won't find an integrating factor by trial and error. In class, you will learn a method to find an integrating factor for any first-order linear differential equation. So you won't miss the next class, will you? Goodbye.